Well, you started off, you were flying in the air, drunk without a care.
A true Aggie legend, the A, where a kiss is more than just a kiss. Here it is a rite of passage. The A was built in 1916 by a group of enterprising young men known as Beanos. Its purpose was to serve as a rite of initiation ritual, wherein each young man had to kiss a willing young lady atop the A under a full moon at midnight. This ritual spread across the entire campus and became known as the method by which one could attain true Aggiehood. One still can become a true Aggie with a kiss on the A under a full moon at midnight by one who is a true Aggie, or on homecoming night by one who is not.
So you think everyone should do it?
I think that if you don't do this by the time you graduate Utah State, you missed out on the experience.
I think it's fun. At least you can say you did it. It's just one of those things that's just for fun.
Something you should do before you graduate?
Preferably. It's like part of graduation requirements.
I think it should be required by the...
It is.
True Aggie Night is probably one of the greatest traditions the school has. I mean, everyone loves kissing, making out, whatever.
Yeah.
Exactly.
I think it is a great, fun thing for the students.
I think it's good, but I think it's a little pathetic that there's so many people that show up that don't kiss, that don't go up there and kiss.
They should be kissing.
They should be kissing.
There's like 80% people here.
Why show up if you're not going to go kiss? So, but yes.
Go kiss.
Well, I'll be honest, it's kind of an interesting tradition, probably. I don't know who the... Well, obviously the Beano Club that started it way back in the day, and then I think a lot of schools have kind of stolen the idea from us. It's an important tradition. I think it's something that you should do at least once in your life. If you're not into making out with a stranger, then do it with someone that you've already kissed before. That's what I would say. But yeah, it's just kind of one of those Utah State rite of passage things. You gotta come, you gotta do it at least once, and it's kind of fun to just come and hang out with friends when you're not.
Yours.
For a little second,
yeah.
It's all right.
Yeah. You
want
to set you up with somebody?
No, I'm okay.
can one of you get your Aggie? Because we have to interview someone who becomes true Aggie. Are both of you true Aggies?
I'm a true Aggie already.
Are you? All right, we'll have to find
out. All right. Thanks.
I think it's kind of weird kissing a random stranger, so when I hear true Aggie, I kiss someone that I knew. It's kind of creepy kissing someone you don't know. They might have herpes.
I've got mono.
So you're
No, I'm not kissing anyone tonight.
Can't touch this.
You just come up and find some random person. You can't come with people that you know. That's no fun.
I'd rather kiss a stranger on the A. I think that would be really fun because you get a piece of paper that says, I think that says your name and the date that you became a true Aggie and who you did it with. And I think it'd be cool just to have some stranger's name that you have no idea who it is.
August 24th, 2010, Alyssa Pope stood atop the A, and while a full moon shone brightly down, was promptly kissed by Bryce Frosty, and shall be be known forever more as a true Aggie, and shall be entitled to all the rights and privileges that accompany this most esteemed title.
So you guys just become true Aggies?
Yes, we did.
Look at that.
Haven't signed the card
yet. Not signed, but we just...
What do you think of people like me that don't want to be true Aggie?
Not to be mean, but you have no business being up here.
Become a true Aggie or you're a loser!
I am not a true Aggie. The reason I'm not a true Aggie is because I so highly esteem and regard the event of becoming a true Aggie that I want to share that special experience with probably my future wife. So since I'm not engaged or married, I'm not a true Aggie.
No, I'm not.
Why not?
The line was too long when I went.
All the way up to the front.
And then when it's not, when the line isn't long, it's too cold, so you don't want to be there.
First become a true Aggie?
Couple months ago, like in February. Yeah.
Was it cold?
Yes.
Worth it?
Sign it.
Sure.
It's so cold!
I'm not a true Aggie, and you know, I heard about it, and I heard it's a great thing, but personally, I prefer studying.
Are you guys true Aggies already?
No.
First time.
Yeah, it is true Aggie, my first year up here.
I am a true Aggie.
True Aggie Night is so important that the seniors this year are refurbishing the A. They're part of their senior gift. They're hoping to be able to raise enough money to be able to level out the A so it's not tilting, as you can see, sinking into the ground, and also being able to put brick pavers around so it doesn't get muddy as it got last night at True Aggie Night. And also to be able to put lights around it so at night you can see it across the quad.
This is for the Student Alumni Association. We're part of the Traditions Committee, and so we put True Aggie on every month. So this is one of the biggest ones along with Homecoming. So for this one, what we did, we just set up like the signs and banners and stuff. We have to have the stairs so people don't fall over themselves. Put up a little Christmas lights to set the mood. We got the DJ in the background on the smaller ones. We'll set up our own little stereo system with someone's iPod on a playlist. And then we also have some volunteers helping out.
Ooh, when I was only just a friend to you, all I wanted to do is get to know you better. And now I want to give my heart to you. Tell me, do you feel like I do when we're together? 'Cause I come alive with your touch. Your touch, it always sets me free. I can't get quite enough. Too much of you is what I need. Yes, I know you're the one. 'Cause love has come alive in me, yeah. Tell me, am I out? Tell me if I'm wasting time, I don't mind giving my love to you. I can't help it, baby. If I asked you, would you say I do? 'Cause